What are you chasing here, Jackie Lily?
Hey boys and girls. We're chasing the Jack, the Chuck Lally. Mostly 3 meter flat.
We're out there. We're going good.
Yeah, boy. Oh, we're on here.
Yeah, little baron, cuter.
So, we're trying to keep the girls happy. Give them a little beach to hang out on, just over here as you can see. And then we don't have an anchor, so we've been using the rock. We've lost two, and then we've been searching these whole cliff faces trying to find a rock for an anchor. And then this is what happens when you try to please the girls. Your mate just goes fishing instead. I think he's a smarter man. All right, stay tuned, I'll try to find some fish.
Yeah, Jackie boy. A little runt for the first start of the day. That's sick.
A little sandy.
Nice little fella go, eh? Here he goes.
So we're just at Horseshoe Bay, is this Jackie?
Yeah, Horseshoe Bay.
We've got a couple of pillies just floating. One's got a sinker, one's just floating bait. Jack's just chucking a little, little black and striped tiger looking vibe.
Pretend we know what we're doing.
Yeah, but it turns out he's got one on that.
So Jack's skull dragging another little fucking perler.
Perch.
It's a pearl perch. Or is it Moses perch?
Finger mark.
Finger mark perch. Give him a look at your lure there, Jack. Yeah.
Same size as the lure there.
Now, have a beautiful day. Magnetic Island, we've been lucky, been gifted with the beautiful weather. Not many fish, Jack got a couple, lucky bastard. Only the little babies though. Here again, middle of the day, still in Magnetic Island, bit hungry, so we're just going for a drive to just see what we can find. We found this lovely little cafe, Drop Bear Cafe. So you know, man, like I said, supporting the locals, but you don't realise it sometimes, but the locals are the ones that have the best to hold and look after you. See what I'm saying? You wouldn't even know this was out here. But you've got lovely food, lovely reception, lovely area. Hey kitty. Good? Alright. So that's Arthur Bay. I know that is Arthur Bay, but this is just a little turnout that I don't think many people would know, but there's a little lookout just here. Straight down. Oh, there's some reefs out there. I reckon that's where we're gonna hit it. I reckon that is the perfect spot. Apparently, so high tide here is not time to snorkel. The water's not clear because it's coming through. I haven't figured it out yet. It doesn't make sense to me, but if your tides are running one way and then your wind's pushing you another way, and you got your coastline here, so the clearer water is on the run out tide, close to the lowest. But I reckon that around now half tide would be probably the best to snorkel, because you still got water on top of your reefs, and that's exactly what we're going to do. It's clear over here, there's no wind over here in these bays. The best thing about an island is that if this bay is windy, or that bay is shit, or the next bay is shit, then you just go to the 10 other bays that are in the other direction.
So it's Arthur Beach, come down. I've seen a big group of people out here snorkeling. There's no one here now, but hopefully there's still some clarity to go for a look. I didn't think there was nets here, but by the looks of it, there actually is. So it should keep the stingrays and, stingers and all other animals out, besides all the smaller ones. And hopefully we can see some stuff.
All right, hitting this reef up to protect it, just in case stingers or anything around here, box jellyfish.
Really good at this, but down at that bay, that one that we are, you know, east bay to the S bay, so we went and had a quick snorkel there. It was fairly clear in the sunlight, so we pretty much had to swim towards the sun or around where the sunbeam was on the water, so that wasn't too bad. It's late arvo, as you can see, sort of good tide for it, lowish. Middle of the day would be perfect. Middle of the day, run out tide almost at the end of it, boom, yeah, that's what you gotta do.
Alright, as you can see, I'm a professional, so I'm just gonna make this up as a professional would. So I'm gonna put water in there just to wash it, literally just to wash the rice. Yeah, white people wouldn't know how to wash rice. I wouldn't think of it, maybe, but you gotta wash the starch out of it. Let me get that cranking. Alright, I'll leave that to the boil, but dead set. You ready? For $60, maybe $70, double burner, Kmart, and you got a non-stick plate, just a proper hot plate, you can't lose with. Easy to clean, $70. I just run off butane, which I had to fix up. Cheap ad.
Great. So, lock your gas, hit your head up, boom, double burner, blow V. So we got Peking duck, a sausage, caramelized onions and rice, heaps of salt and pepper. It's big. Big.
Oh my god.
Big. Big. Oh my god. Oh my god. For the rod.
Oh my god.
He's still going.
Gone?
Oh my god, there was too much hurt on him. What? Oh.
Oh yeah.
Let me wash him.
Whoa. It's a brim.
I don't know what it is.
Is it a brim?
It's a big fish.
Yeah.
It's a perch of some sort. Yeah, boy.
What have we got?
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Shit. Oh.
No way.
Oh. He's going sideways, honey.
Oh no.
There you have it. That's Magnetic Island. We're back on the boat now going home. Unfortunately, we only could get the 6 o'clock barge back, which
we probably could have spent another morning running the round. Maybe went for a snorkel in the morning, just after low tide. But it's all good. We had about pretty much two full days to explore it, and it was definitely enough. We had our own cars. If you don't have a car, then you can hire these little Suzukis, which are awesome. They're cool little cars anyway, so you probably have fun just, you know, just thrashing around in those things and get you everywhere you needed to go. Two old days, definitely enough. Heaps of accommodation here, heaps of restaurants, heaps of cafes. Everything's nice as. We were gifted the good weather, which is definitely an upside. But yeah, keep an eye on your tides, and snorkeling I reckon is a definite. You just gotta talk with the locals and find out exactly when the best time for you to go. Run out of tide, near low, hopefully middle of the day would be perfect. Fishing, we had little luck, but at the same time we had a bit of luck. Last night me and Mrs. we had some luck, we were chucking out prawns, and we got a couple of big screamers, snapped off twice on the heavy rod, so I don't know what that was, but he was going both times. And then we got a little perch, some sort of perch, I don't know exactly what it was. But yeah, the fish are out there, so bring your rods, get into it, have fun.
Feels a little fire today.